Welcome back from Derek Dash's World. Now, it's about that time we get into one-on-one. You know, earlier on this year, we started this segment with the hope that you will get to find out about the artists that you've been longing for, the artists that you watch on TV, but also a platform for the young, the people who are trying to build their careers, for young entrepreneurs, for artists, for musicians, for dancers, you name it. Now, that is the reason as to why we have this segment called One-on-One. Now, today we have a single mother. We all know it's Woman Crush Wednesday. She goes by the name of Julz, and she has a one hit single. She'll be working on one other that will be released in October, early. But right now, let's head into One-on-One. I'll be right back. Welcome back to the show. It is a beautiful Wednesday, and One-on-One right here on Living Urban Television. Now, you know, I get so emotional when I'm going to have an interview with a lady who I relate with. Now, this lady is very, very talented, I have to say. She is signed under African Cozy African, and it's a label company that's just new. It's a baby, but it's doing a good job. And she has a new hit single called Ngukuba Kochi.
Boy, you know, you turn me on. Ain't you calling Tangawe? Cause they don't go feed a call. I think it on the way to go. Yeah, eh. What I'm saying, I'm born, son, you, sir. You could be a father. Eh, to the Montalo, Wobuala, Obulala Tebukusuza.
Wow, that's cute. That's cute. You know, speaking of the fact that your song is in Uganda.
Yeah.
And, so many times when you're our age, people like want to speak English all that time. I'm so happy that you're promoting the local language. Oh, before I even say I'm so happy you're promoting the local language. Mm. Did you want to sing in Luganda, or is it because that's what sells at the moment?
Okay, to be honest, I wanted to sing in English. But then along the way, everyone was like, no, English doesn't work, blah, 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 blah. So you have to... And this is my first time singing in Uganda, so it was hard. Mm. Like the whole
time. Are you a Muganda?
No, I'm Uganda.
Oh, so why was it hard? Don't you forget Uganda?
No, okay, the words, the visokos in there that were kind of hard for me to, you know, to say in the song while recording. So they were kind of hard for me, but then, yeah, finally I nailed it.
Wow, that's nice. Mm. Now, I didn't mention that Julz has been in the industry for 8 years. Now, most you go to other stations, other TV, they'll ask you, how is it? How? But now let's go back to those 8 years, because there's some people who don't know the real Julz. They don't know. And that's why people want to know the beauty of it, the hustle. Where did you start from? Those 8 years, what were you doing?
The 8 years, I was doing, like, begging for bands, like, to sing for them. And, you know, like, going to bars, and you're like, oh, my God, I want to sing. You want to get, like... You want everyone to know, like, you can really sing. It was a real hustle. And then at that time, I had a job. Yeah, I had
a
thing.
Working?
I was working at a construction company. Yeah, as an admin there. So it was hard for me. Like, I had to, this was my passion from way back. Mm-hmm. I would leave work, go to a bar, and like hustle. I mean, tell these the band guys, Gen Z band and stuff like that. Like, I need to do, you know, auditions, and I need to, like, try out, like, a host, like a guest artist. And like that, I mean, people started seeing me, like, in bars and stuff like that. That's where African...
That's where he met you. That's very interesting for you to leave a job to chase your dream.
No, I didn't actually leave it. I was still working. Mm. Yeah, but I used to do it in the night.
Okay.
Yeah, after work, I used to go, like, every night I would go, like, you know, try to see that I could sing, people could see me. It was really, it's a hustle.
It's a hustle, yeah. And it is the hustle up to now. Still, but still, beauty. The beauty with hustling through it is, at the end of the day, you get what you want. Now, this is a myth that I had, and so many people out there have, but I want you to be the myth buster.
Okay.
So many people believe that when you record a song and you release it, ofunirawo sente. First, when we see your song on TV, we envision that, ha, Julz.
Azikute, yes.
Azikute.
Yeah.
Tell us, how is it? Is it really what we think it is?
No, it's not what you think. And it's the same thing that has been happening with my friends. You know, you meet your friends, they expect you to be splashing money. And because they think, oh, your video's on TV, it's been played on TV, so they think you have money. No, it's after you've done, like, let me say, an album or maybe 4 songs. People get too excited, and then what's next, you get. Mm. But then you have to do like 4 or 5 songs that are good hits so that you go, you're being called on gigs, perform on, that's when you start making money.
You know, yeah. I've talked about this and I think it's becoming a routine. Yes, we have admitted that this industry does not have money. You understand? But this industry has a lot of young people. This industry has a lot of talent.
Yeah.
What do you think can be put there to push the industry so that people can actually start making some money? Because we want good work as Ugandans. So what do you think we can do about it?
No, I think I should correct you on that. I think the music industry has a lot of money.
Really?
Yes, it does.
Yes. I like this because we're going to have an argument. Mm-hmm.
Yes, I think, I really think it is because I have a few friends who are artists, yeah? And, okay, the music industry, you have to have money to invest in yourself. So you invest, it's like a business.
But that's,
invest money to get money. Mm. And the money you get is 10 times plus the money you invested. That's if you've invested good money. And say you've invested in good videos, good songwriters, and then production, all those things. When the music is hard and people listen to it, the shows that you make bring back that money to you.
Yeah, but like, so you see, the problem is, like we just talked about it, Juma.
Yeah.
It takes time. You understand?
Yeah, it does.
It takes time, and that's the problem we're having here.
But I think every business takes time. Because if you compare,
does. Let me give an example. It's different from like, for example, if me and you were both 25 and I start working in a bank. Yeah. At least I'll know Jacob and Fneoka 800 as I'm working on my career to build it up. That's what I'm trying to say. That this industry, you start on a basis of zero.
Yeah,
there's no support system, Juma. There's no support from the government, from the musicians themselves. There's no support for young artists there who have talent. They can't. You're lucky, Juma. You have someone who's going to boost it financially. You get what I'm trying to tell you? So that's where I'm coming in from.
Okay, about that, and I was talking about it with a few friends of mine, and a few friends are like, you know, I mean, they keep saying, yeah, you're lucky, but then they don't know the HS, the water hustle. But I really feel the government should really work so hard because we have so much talent, Lebanon music.
Mm.
We have so many good dancers out there. We have so many girls who can do sports. Like, I mean, there's so much talent in Uganda. So I think the government should really, really, really work so hard to make
like
sure.
Like an incentive of like when you have just started into the music career.
At least they give you
an incentive.
Yeah.
Like transportation to the music, you know. It's you register somewhere.
You register somewhere. I mean, like how the government has done, there's a free beauty kind of thing, they, you know, for girls and stuff. I think they should do also a free musical school, like for people to go. We need, besides talent, people, they need
because
to be a school.
Because if I had someone who was writing for me and they were good, and I knew someone could help me push something, then nange sina kuteka munyo. But imagine, this girl is from campus, but she wants to be a musician. Now she has to get money for her video. Videos are not cheaper than 5 million shillings. She has to pay a writer. Then there's studio sessions. You get what I'm trying to tell you?
And it's hard.
And the fact that we are women. And I always ask these questions. People think it will never grow old.
Mm.
The fact that the music industry, and I'll not stop saying it until they stop portraying women as sex objects, even in my industry.
True.
You understand?
Yeah.
How are you going to fight that as a woman? Because you're a woman and you are a mother. And are you planning to have more babies?
No, now.
Okay, but someday.
Yes, yeah, someday.
You get what I'm trying
someday,
to tell you? Why does this industry, I talked about it with Nina Rose, why does this industry keep portraying women like sex objects?
I mean, it's not the industry. I think it's everywhere. Yes, I think it's everywhere. With you have a housemaid home. She's being, you know, like it's the thing. Every woman is taken like a sex, which is not a good thing.
Yeah.
But then when you're in the music industry, it is
it's worse.
It's worse because now you're going to go to the producer, and then he's going to write for you a song. But then after that, you want something else. I mean, for me, I mean, speaking for myself, I've been lucky that I haven't faced that kind of side of, you know. But then it happens. You hear stories about some girls going through that, and you're like, oh, my God. And then some are being used, and then they don't get what they want. So it's really, really, really tough.
Is that the reason as to why parents are hesitant? Because let me tell you, this is growing. Yeah, this is a growing industry. And, like, we want to be like the developed countries, Juma, whereby we also promote talent. Apart from kids becoming doctors, we want to promote talent.
True.
But is that the reason as to why people are hesitant to put their kids in their industry? Like, first of all, we sent a Butini, Atoro agenda mukoze
sa. I know. That's why you find most parents who have a little bit of money, they tend to invest in their children, not to just let them go out and stuff and be like, oh my God, just go out and, you know, because there's so many hungry men out there. Even not even the hungry men, but even the artists that want to take advantage of the new artists you get. So most parents take care of that. Mm-hmm. Some that don't, that's what you find some girls doing what they don't like, but then they wanted to do music.
Yeah, so that means we shouldn't portray women and sometimes abuse them. Oh, she's, and give those tarnishing names like HOE and BITCH, yeah. Because sometimes we're put in positions where we don't want to be.
Yeah,
now let's talk back into the music. Tell me, when you're pushing for this song and this, and you know, who wrote it, the ideas, where did it come from?
The idea, Nkobako Ochi, you know, like most of the times when you want your first song, you tell the producer what you want and what the story behind everything you want to. So he was like, you know what? I think I have a song for you, because I told him what I wanted the song to be like.
Mm.
And he's like, you know, I have a song for you. And the first time I heard it, I was like, yes, this is my song.
Mm.
Yeah, so this, the songwriter is called St. Andrews. Mm. He's really a talented man out there. He's going to write most of my songs on this album because he's really talented.
He's going to write so many of your songs, but don't you feel like, for example, these days, even Beyonce, even internationally, people switch up things. They don't work with only one person because things switch up, or you just feel like this person gets you.
This person, it's like let me say a kindergarten teacher. The first person that gets to you, you don't want to just, you know, like because you have two songs that you run away to another person and stuff. I just feel like I'm comfortable with him right now, and he gets me. Every time we're in the studio, he tells me, no, this is not right. No, this is not right. So he tells me, I do vocal drills with him like a million times. He makes you work. I've been to so many studios before I did this, but you'd find most producers after the money. They don't care if you're nailing it, if you're doing the note right. They don't care about that.
That's beautiful. But when we get back, because we have to take a short break, we'll be talking about how do you tell a good song? Because, you know, there's so many times when they've written for you, so many, but then you have to pick from something, and I know this is going to hit. Then we'll be talking about more about the music career and where you see yourself and the projects you'll be working on. I hope you have some projects you're working on.
Yeah.
We'll be right back.